straighten that. In our previous session, we have discussed about some notations of ER modeling. We have also discussed about some examples where I have given some problem to you and asked for the notations, the ER diagram. We have also seen how to present a diagram for given problems like the NOC system, which I have discussed in my previous example. There are many more examples. You can go through the books and referred materials. You can also visit to my files to see different examples. You can take the questions about the examples and draw the ER diagram by yourself. You can also go through the books like Namate or other good books. You will find a lot of examples there. You can go and do your practice, and if you have any problem, you can meet to the faculty. Here we are now extending our work to the double ER modeling. Double ER modeling. This is basically enhanced ER modeling. This is basically enhanced ER modeling. Some authors also used to say this is extended ER modeling. ER for entity relationship modeling. Hence, you can say enhanced entity relationship modeling or extended entity relationship modeling. Here, some concepts which were not in the ER modeling were introduced in the case of in the title of double ER modeling, like subclasses and inheritances. Subclasses and inheritance. So, what is a subclass or inheritance? Let us see. If there are two entity types like A and B, there are two entity types like A and B. If I am saying that B is a subclass of A, if I am saying that B is a subclass of A, then it must follow is a relationship. If I say B is a subclass of A, then it must follow is a relationship. How I will say this? If B is a subclass of A, then B is a subclass of A. This will follow is a relationship. There are some more things we will go through when we will explore this topic. We will study about specialization, we will study about generalization, and different terms like aggregation will also introduce in the our coming lecture. If I write an example that like car is a vehicle, it means this is the car and this is the vehicle. It is following is a relationship. It means it is a subclass of vehicle class. It means car is a class or subclass of the parent vehicle class. I am not going with some formal notations here in our coming discussions. I will also go through the formal notations where I will notate how to notate the generalization, specialization, or subclasses like this, or aggregation. Here I am just informally showing you how we read a subclass, that B is a subclass of A, it can follow or is a relationship. Like, and take another example. Monkey is a animal. Like this, monkey is an animal. You can also say manager is a employee. Means manager is a subclass of superclass employee. This is A and this one is B. And this one is a subclass relationship. Fine? What does it mean? It means if B is a child or subclass of class A, then it will have all the properties like attributes and relationships of A also. It means to say, what the properties and properties like attributes and functions or relations are there with A will be there in B also, because B is a child class. One thing also we can note here, that B has its another properties also along with the parent property, because B is a new version. You can say B, that is the child class, is a new version of a parent class or base class A. Hence, it has all the properties which are coming from the parent class, and also it has some new properties which are new for it, which we have added to B as a new version as a B class. Hence, if I am taking an example, like I am saying that vehicle is a class, or vehicle is an entity having different properties like color, like name, like model, like model year, like this. It has different properties, and this vehicle is associated with another entity like employees. Employees. Employee. These vehicles are used by employees. These vehicles are used by employees. This is a database. This is a ER database for a given company where there is a vehicle which are used by employees. There is a child class of this vehicle like car. Car is a vehicle. This is following is a relationship. Hence car is a child or subclass of this vehicle. How we notate this subclass? Use this particular notation like this. Use this particular notation to notate the subclasses. It shows that this car is a child of a subclass of this vehicle class. We are studying here type inheritance. What is the type inheritance here? For in this example, there are some properties with this vehicle or this parent class. What are the properties here? There are some attributes which I have shown here. Attributes have one more thing, a relationship used by with another entity type, that is the employee. It means there are vehicles and these are used by the employees. This one is the child of or subclass of this vehicle class. If I replace, I am studying type inheritance. It means the car entity type must have all the attributes which are there in its parent class or entity, parent entity. It means all these attributes along with some new attributes should be there in this particular entity type. And along with this, one more thing, this relationship should also be there in this entity type. This relationship should also be there in the child or subclass entity type. What it means to say, if you replace this vehicle by car or subclass, this is the important thing in the subclassing. What is this? First thing, child will contain all the properties coming from the parent. Second thing, if we replace this parent class by the child, it will show all the properties and all the relationships similar to the way as it was there in the case of parent class. It must follow. If it is not follow or if it is not feasible, then the pattern which are taken, the parent class relationship is not the correct way. It is not in the correct way basically. Hence, it must satisfy the same relationships which were present in the case of along with the parent. This is known as type inheritance in subclasses. You can see here, there is a parent class. Which one is a parent class? Employee is a parent class and manager is a child class or subclass. You can say manager is a subclass of employee or manager is a employee. Manager is a employee. This shows, this symbol shows is a relationship or subclasses. Here, parent number is a primary, the PAN number is a key attribute of employee class. What is the key attribute? This attribute is used to identify uniquely the employees. It will help to identify employees uniquely. In this relationship, manager, this PAN number, which is the unique, this is the key in this particular class, must be a key in the manager subclass also. This manager subclass will have all the attributes along with this parent and relationship in the in itself also. It will also have the relationships which were given in the employee. This parent number is also work as a unit, is also work as a key in the manager subclass also. It may have some more keys also, some more new keys also, but the parent number is also coming from the its parent class, hence it will also present in this particular class. It will have also some new keys up there. So what is specialization and generalization? Specialization and generalization. The process of creating subclasses of given entity is basically specialization. You are moving from top to bottom. You have some bigger class and you are going for some subclass. It is more specialized to this. You can say this is the community of doctors, this is the doctor, and these are childs like cardiologist, like physician, like other doctors, community. These are more specialized to parent one. This is general form having major properties. These are specialized form of this major form having some more specific properties. Like this is cardiologist, another one is the gastrologist, another one is the urologist, like this. These are the specialization. So, if we are moving like this, from top to bottom, this is known as specialization. If we have many specialized classes, institutionalized classes, and we are moving. Hence, we will club all these classes to form a generalized class. In this way. This is known as generalization. This is just reverse to the specialization. In this specialization, you move from a generalized, a bigger class, to more specific class from top to bottom. And in generalization, you have many more classes or many more specialized classes. You will club all these classes and to form a very generalized class which will define all these classes. This is the process from bottom to top. This is the bottom of process. This one, bottom to top. If we are moving from top to bottom, this is the specialization. Just reverse. Same thing, just reverse. You have the many more classes, you are just clubbing to a general class. You have many more classes, you are just clubbing to a single class. Moving from bottom to top, this is the generalization. So specialization is basically creating subclasses, and generalization is basically you have many subclasses and you are forming a generalized class. This is a superclass. Now some more things on the generalization. Some more thing on generalization. Let us understand with some example here. You have two classes. First one is the secretary. It has some attributes like salary, pen, it is a unique or key attribute, and skill set. And the one you have manager. Another entity type, manager, having salary, pen, and experience. See, these two entities, one is the secretary, having salary attribute, pen as attribute, skill as attribute, and manager having salary, pen, and experience as the attribute. If you are seeing that there are more than one classes or entities having a very good extent of same or similar attributes, then you can generalize to a single entity type to form a generalized class. You can generalize this. You can see here there is a salary and pen. There are three attributes. Among these three attributes, there are two attributes which are common. This is a very good extent to take a decision that this is a good case for generalization. You can go with the generalization like here, which I am showing here. You can generalize this as employee. Move all the common attributes to this generalized class. What are the common attributes like salary, pen, and This is the secretary. And this one is the manager. Put their individual or their unique attributes along with them. Like the skill is associated with secretary, hence put this skill with the secretary. Put this experience with the manager. Put this experience with the manager. This is a very generalized representation of these given classes, which have a very good strength of or a very, up to a very good extent, they have a common property. They have common property this like salary and pen. These two common properties will go with the generalized class, and the individual properties which are associated along with only them will go with their with these entity types. Like skill is going with the secretary and the manager. Oh, sorry, this is not a manager. This is the experience. Experience property will go with the manager. This is the representation of generalization, how we represent. And one more thing, when we correct this thing, this one is the generalization. Don't forget to use the notation of generalization. It will not be correct if you will not go with the proper notation. You have to use this generalization notation. One more thing, what is D here? D shows the disjoint set. What is the disjoint set? No secretary can be a manager, and no manager can be a secretary. These two sets or these two entities are completely different. No manager can be a secretary, and no secretary can be a manager. This will be represented with the help of a disjoint notation, that is the D, which is shown here. This is the inherent circle. How to represent disjoint or overlapping? You will see very soon what is the overlapping. This is the basically disjoint represented with the help of capital D. Some others also represent with the help of small d also. That represents disjoint. Predicate. Predicate, define subclasses. Predicate defines subclasses. What are the predicate defined subclasses? It means the subclassing will depend on some question, or the it will depend on the some value of some attribute of parent class. What I mean to say, if you have some superclass, it must have some properties. There is a property which is not represented with the help of circle, which is a very common way to represent the attributes or properties. This attribute or property will help will use to represent on the arrows or the connectors, where it will be represented as a property which is asking some answer. Like, what is your job type? Is it secretary, for the secretary, or is it for the administration or for the education? If you belongs to for the, if answer is for the administration, you will go for the admin department. If you belongs, your answer is related to the education field, then you will go for the faculty department. Means this attribute or predicate is again a part of, or it is itself an attribute of parent class having some values. At the time of subclassing, the question will be there, what the value what the value should be there for this particular entity, particular DTP attribute. If this belongs to, if the answer is belongs to particular category, it will go on the category. If answer belongs to another category, the classification or the grouping will be go in the some different category. Like, let us see with the example. This is very simple. You have employee as a class. Pay and salary are the attributes. Employee is a super class, a generalized class. The secretary and the professors are the subclasses or the specialized classes. Here, job type is the attribute of employee, but this is not shown with the help of some circle or ellipse. It has two values. One is the admin and another is one is the academic. It has two values. Job type has two values: academic and admin type. If you are subclassing the employees, or you are making a class or the child of the employee class, there are two values of, on based on the job type. There are two type of classes because there are two values of the job type. One value will one type of class should be there based on the admin, and the class should be there based on the academic nature of the job type. This is again the disjoint. This can be overlapping. Disjoint is it depends on the nature of your subclassing. If secretary is also possible, it's not possible basically, but if this class is also possible to belong to this class, it should be overlapping. If this class also can be this class, member of this class, this can be overlapping. But in this case, particular case, no secretary can be a professor and no professor can be a secretary. And this is a disjoint. This is the predicate type. These are the values of this predicate. And based on these values, there are two subclasses. One is the secretary and another one is the professor. And this is known as predicate defined subclasses. Now, what is the overlapping? This O. Here we have, I have taken the string Yapal. What is the overlapping? it shows basically some contents of this particular subclass can belong to this particular subclass. It means there are some professors that can be chair professors. Chair professors are basically those professors which are particularly associated with the project works. They are funded by some other government institutions or some other institutions, but still they are enrolled with some university or college where they are working as an honorary professor, but specifically they are associated with the projects. Professors are those persons in the institution or college, those are listed in that particular institution or college, and those are associated for taking the lectures, and they can also take the projects from the either from the institution or from the other sides. Hence, some chair professors are there, they can also take the lectures like the other professors. Hence, some chair professors can be professor. There are some professors in the institute, they can also take the project from the other side and from the institute also. Hence, they are also behaving like a chair professor. It means some contents, some elements of this particular entity type also belongs to this group. Some professors or some entity type, some entities from this particular set or from this entity type belongs also to this particular group. Hence, this is an overlapping set. If there is a restriction, no chair professor will be a professor, and no professor is there as a chair professor, then these groups are the disjoint. In that particular case, it should be a capital small D. This is O in this particular case when the case is overlapping. O represents the overlapping. A database named as account holder. Either the account holder is some individual or some family or some institution. To abstract their details or for the hiding purpose, to hide their details, they use a common notation like abstraction, account holder. Either it is a individual, he or she is a account holder. Either it is a institution, again it is account holder. Either it is some family, which is again account holder. Hence this type of things are used to abstract or hide the details. To hide the details we go with the abstraction. And these categories of account holder, like account holder is individual, account holder is some family, account holder is some institution, they have their own unique or they have their own attributes as a key attribute. These all belongs to the same type of entity like account holder. This type of things are known as union. So let us understand with the example. Subclasses like some individual, some family, some institution, you have different entity types, which are a category of this account holder, which are the type of account holder. You can show them like this. Use capital U to represent the union. Use capital U to represent the union. What I am discussing here, this account holder can be an individual, this account holder can be a family, this account holder can be an institute. Fine. They have their own key attributes, but still they are a type of or category of account holder. These are basically used to have the details. If all the individuals, all the records belongs to the account holder database or the account holder, then this is known as complete union or full union. But if there are some account holders in the given database are not the account holder, basically they are there for the promotion works. They are used for different purpose, like the banks used to send the SMS for their promotions for different products, like their mutual funds, for their some banking proposals. They also used to keep the list or the record of different individuals which are presently not their customer or not their client. But these records are used in future work for sending the SMSs, for sending the other things, postal cards, for some purpose, like some banking issues or some sort of banking purposes. But in this case, if all the records are account holder, then this is the complete or full union type. If not all the records belong to given account holder database or the account holder, in this case this is known as the partial union type. Hence this can be either partial or this can be either full or complete union type. In this way we have discussed a lot on the ER relations. One more thing is there, aggregation. What is the aggregation? In case of aggregation, basically you combine two entities with a relationship and treat it like a single entity. In case of aggregation, listen again, in case of aggregation, you combine two entities with some relationship and treat it as a single entity. This is known as aggregation. This is basically combining two entities. So we have, in this way we have discussed many more things, approximately all the concepts of the ER modeling, double ER modeling, ER different notations. We have also discussed different problems based on the ERs, ER diagrams, or given problems for the real life problems. In this way we have completed the topic of ER, double ER. In next session we will go for the relational modeling, where we will discuss with the relational operators and many more things. Thank you for watching.